The term polyp, when used in a medical context, may be defined as a morbid excrescence or protruding growth, usually from the surface of an organ. And the term polyp is purely descriptive. It does not imply what it is composed of, the pathogenesis, i.e. what causes it to arise, or its behaviour. Polyps often arise from a mucous membrane. A very good example would be adenomatous polyps arising from the large bowel mucosa. If polyps are flat, these are called sessile polyps. If they are pedunculated, that means they have a stalk. Polyps may be benign, dysplastic, or malignant. And if something is polyp-shaped, it may be referred to as polypoid. Here are some examples of some very common polyps, and they include fibroepithelial polyps, adenomatous polyps, endocervical polyps, endometrial polyps, and nasal polyps, to name but a few. There are some conditions characterized by multiple polyps, and a very good example of this is familial polyposis coli. This is an adenomatous polyp arising in the rectum. Here we can see multiple polyps, and this is an example of familial polyposis coli. And here is an example of a malignant polyp. This is a polypoid carcinoma of the stomach. In addition, it has a rather broad stalk, but it would still be described as pedunculated. Of course, not all polyps are epithelial, and here is an example of a fibroid that has protruded through the endometrial cavity out of the cervix, and this is an example of a fibroid polyp.